going to read about the basics of Swift. Firstly, like you know about the Swift Doc. It's a Swift Doc website. You can read everything from here. Firstly, we are reading about constant and variable. As a name suggests, constant are the constant, like when they will be declared once, we can't change their values. But in case of variables, we can change the values of variables. Like, there is a playground in which we can we can play from with Swift. You can learn Swift here. So firstly, like how we create a constant. So to creating constant, firstly we take a keyword, write a keyword let this will call let declaration. So we are declaring the name of the variable or constant. So in case of let, we are creating the constant, the name of the constant, something like str equal to the value. So it's the value can be string, integer, or any other. So firstly, we are using with string. So as we know, to write a string, we are using quotation, double quote. The value between the string, like a name, Harsh. Now printing the value of str. Print str. Now we run the code. To run the code, just click on it, and you can see there will be running the lesson. Like it print the name Harsh. Now if we want to change the value of str, so we try to change the value str equal to Sumit and we try to run it. So you can see the compiler gives some error. And what it telling is, cannot assign the value of str is a let constant. Means we can't change the value because it is a constant. And secondly, he tell change let to where to make it mutable. If you want to mutate it, if you want to change the value, then you need to make it where. So where is the variable? To declare a variable, now we are going from start. To declare a variable, it's same like constant. Just keyword are changed. For constant, we are using let as a keyword. For variable, we are using var as a keyword. You can see var declaration. Var the name, something called str again. Name of the variable and the value of variable. So now we are again using the string as a variable value. So again we printing the value. So you can see it's print Harsh. Now we change the value. And print again. Print. Again. Again. So you can see, firstly, str is a value as a hash, so it print the hash. Now str is a value as Sumit, so it print the Sumit. And we are writing some constant here, like again, so it will also print this. So basically, as we from document, constant and variable must be declared before they are used. Yeah, we need to declare it before use. Like if we are not declaring this and we try to compile it, then it will give, because it did not have anything named like str. So it tell used of unresolved identifier str. Now if we provide the variable here, it will run fine. You declare a constant with the let keyword and variable with the where keyword, as we also know about this. Here the example. Now next thing is type annotation. In first case, we just declaring variable, their variable name and their value. So it will be classified by the variable which type of it have. Like currently it have a string. Now if we change it to int, integer value, so it have int, you can see. So basically it's no by itself what it have, what type of data it have. But if we need to tell the compiler what type of data we need to save in the variable or we need to store in the variable, so if we want to tell, we using the type annotation. To declare with type annotation, we just need to use a colon in the type like string. So now where is a string type? If you want to provide the value of a string, so we can provide here str hash. Also we can provide here Sumit. So like previous we read, it's a where, we tell him it's a variable. Now the the name of the variable, the type of the variable and the initial value of the variable. Because it is a variable, we can change the value. So here we can change the value. If it's a constant, in case of constant, we write let as a keyword tell it's a constant, the name of the constant, the type of the constant and the initial value of the constant. But constant is a constant, so its initial value and final value is the same. So we can't change the value, so it will compiler give us an error. So now it's working fine. So you can read here, you can provide a type annotation when you declare a constant or a variable. You can provide in both case, constant and variable. To be clear about the kind of value the constant of or variable can store, like which type of data they can store. So we need to, we can tell the compiler about the for variable and constant. Write a type annotation by placing a colon after the constant or variable name, followed by the space, followed by the name of type to use. Like we are welcome message colon and the type. Now the naming conventions of variable and constant. To provide the name, there will be some rule. First, I am writing here the rules. First rule, name of variable only can contain alphabets number and underscore. Second, it can be start only with alphabets and underscore. So what is the meaning of this? Like, if we want to declare a constant, so to declare a constant we need to use the let keyword. So we're just using the let, and now the name. So to writing a name we need to use the naming convention. So what are the rule? Firstly, we can only use alphabet and underscore. Like, if we want to use the first letter as a digit and then write a name of the variable, like type, we provide the type notation string, so it will give some error. T is not a valid integer literal, because then it will think it's a literal, it's not a name of variable. If we remove this, and then it's working fine. But we can provide the name number in the last, like type 9. We can't start with digit, but we can give the value or the digit value in between the name or in the last of the name. If we want to use some special character, like then it will give some error because it did not know about him. But if we want to use underscore, then it will be working fine. So also we can name it with start with underscore type. It's properly working fine. So it's naming convention just have two rules. First rule, the name only can contain alphabets. Alphabets means A, B, C, D, E, F or any other language alphabets. And numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9 and underscore. And it only can start with alphabet and underscore. So here we go. Constant variable name can contain almost any character including Unicode character. Constant variable name can't contain white space characters, mathematical symbols, arrows, private use, Unicode scalar values, line and box drawing characters, nor can they begin with a number, although number may be including somewhere else within the name. Once you have declared a constant variable of certain type, you can't change the declaration it again. Yeah, like if we create the type with a string and provide the value something called something, but now we want to change the value but let's give error because it's a let. We can't mutate let values. So firstly we declare it where not working fine. But if we want to provide the value as an integer here, it again gives some error because type can be only decided once. We can't change the type of data again and again. So firstly we create with a string. Now we want to change it as an integer. It can't work. Like it give cannot assign value of type int to type string, because our variable is type string and we want to assign the value as an int. If we are thinking about printing the constant and variable, we did not, it's not, did not need a much work. Just you need to call the print function with, like you can see here, if we are writing print, we can provide the items. So item are the variable names or string literal or number literal, anything. So if we want to print only str, we can use the str as we printing before. If we want to print all these variables, we can just provide the comma between them and we can print it. It can take multiple values. Yeah, this is the error because we can't use any variable before initialization. So we just initialize it with this. So first str as a Sumit, type line as a something, and type as a anything. Comments. If you want to write some comments on your code, like if you want to tell about something about the function, about the variable, you can use the double slash to comment it. When the compiler runs, it don't consider comment in code. It just consider the lines which are not commented. So compiler firstly compile this line, then skip those two lines, then third line, fourth line compile, fifth line compile, and sixth line compile. So result you can see here. It will run in first line compiler, then in second line, in third line, but we are not initializing any value. It did not have any value here. We are initializing the value here, so it's heavy here. Now we are printing the values, so compiler like same, but it skip these comments. If we are just want a single line comment, so we are using double slash. But if we want multiple line comments, so we need to just mention slash star and multiple lines, anything. Compiler can't consider these things. It skip all. You can see. If we print here anything, it compile, but if we commented this print, it can't compile this again. You can see it escaped this. Semicolon, what is the use of semicolon? We can use the semicolon in the last of any variable declaration in any line. It's like a separator of line. So we can use two separators. First one, the enter, like we have two line here. If we want to merge them, we are using separator as a enter, or we can use a separator as a semicolon. No, this work fine. But if we did not use semicolon and we just want to run this, it gives some error because we are not using any separator. So conjugative statements on a line must be separated by semicolon. What are the basic data type Swift have? Yeah, Swift has integers. Integers means the numbers. Any number, it can be zero, it's positive number, it's negative number. So to declare an integer, we use int, doint, unsigned integers. Unsigned integer only have the positive numbers, not can be negative. Now we have floating type numbers, floating which have the decimal, and the decimal value, it's again, it can be anything 1.1, 1.0, 1.2, and 3.4, and minus 3.4, any positive, negative decimal numbers. It also have a string, it have a bool, so we are just using all these things here. We remove this code. Now firstly we declare a string, comment string. So we have a string, so we can declare any variable with a string. Let str string, the type annotation and the initial value, initial value. We have integer, let number, type int, and any value. We have a uint, unsigned integer, let unsigned. Uint. Now we can't assign the signed integer to here. If we come run this, because it's unsigned, so it can't be signed. It only can positive numbers. But number can be a negative value, integer or any other number. We have float. Right. Decimal. Number type float. We can provide any float value. We have double is like a float, but difference is the range. Double have high range from the float. This can be any big value. Small or big, anyone. Now a bool. Bool is just telling about the true false boolean value. लेट बोल, नेम कैन बी एनीथिंग, इट्स नॉट डिपेंड अपॉन टाइप. डिक्लेयर वी आर बोल, इफ वी आर यूजिंग बोल, इट कैन बी ट्रू एंड फॉल्स. सो दीज आर सम बेसिक डाटा टाइप और वी हैव लॉट्स ऑफ मोर. वी आर यूजिंग ऑल दीज इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर और नेक्स्ट टाइम. लाइक नाउ नेक्स्ट इज टाइप शिफ्ट एंड टाइप इन्फ्रेंस. बेसिकली इफ वी डिड नॉट प्रोवाइड एनी टाइप अनोटेशन टू एनी वैल्यू, लाइक वी रिमूव इट, it will be declared by itself. Like it, no, I have the only bool value here, so it's know about the true is a bool value and we it can only contain the bool value. If we want to change to string, it gives a error because it's know only about bool. Firstly, it gives the error of let. But it, now it's only gives the error of type safety. So it's called the type safety. We can't change the type once we provide it. And because it know about the type before without any type of annotation, so it this is called type inference. Inference. Now literals. Literal are the static values, like this is the string literal initial value in double quotes. This is the integer literal. This is the float or double literal, and this is the bool literal. Bool literal only get true and false. So literal, numeric literal, numeric values. Bools. These are basics. Now we are going to move on the data types. There are three type of data and basically two type of data. Firstly, reference type, like classes, secondly value type like structure and enum. So how to what are difference and how to declare. So firstly we go with structure and enum with the value types. So enum, what is the enum? Enum just the collection of same type of data type, like if you want to create a day type enum, it can be the days. So it can be Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. So for declaring enum, we are using keyword as enum. The name of enum, like days, and the cases, that values of enum. So cases is Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and last Saturday. Now we use the day enum. So firstly we declare a variable where the name today तो टाइप एनोटेशन, तो डेज टाइप, बिफोर दिस वी आर जस्ट यूजिंग द प्रिमिटिव टाइप्स इंटीजर फ्लोट स्ट्रिंग, नाउ वी आर डिक्लेयरिंग आवर ओन टाइप. सो द वैल्यू लाइक टुडे इज अ वेडनेसडे और थर्सडे. Now, if we want to print it.